Have you seen my Word top 10 video? It became very popular. Have a look. And then I thought, why not create one for Excel as well? So here we go. Top 10 settings you will love and you must do immediately for Excel. So the first item is very simple. Please pin Excel to taskbar. We open Excel files hundreds of times every day. So why go to Start menu Excel, pin it to the taskbar, but that's not all. Move that taskbar button to the first position. Now Windows 1 will start Excel. And recent files can be opened right there by using the right click menu. And the frequently used files can be pinned as well. So simple taskbar can help us improve productivity. The next one is about file links. Finally, people have understood how to use cloud files. So nowadays people are not sending attachments, they are sending links to files. That is great. It's more productive and more secure. Problem is, if you get a mail with a link in it and you click on it, instead of opening it in Excel desktop, it first opens on browser. Then you have to open one more drop down and then you have to say open in desktop app. That's very irritating. If you have a need, there is always a solution. Just have to find it. Remember? So go to File Options, Advanced, and use this option. What is the option? It's a long name, but basically it says if it's a link which can be opened in Office desktop, it will. So now I click the link, it opens in Excel directly. Simple. Next one. What is Excel about? It's data and formulas. Only two things in Excel. And this is something to do with formulas. Here is a formula. I am calculating average. Now that average can be calculated using average function, or I can just say sum divided by number of items. Now in this case, there is an empty cell. Average function ignores empty cells. So it'll give you a different average than the other method. Now there is no right or wrong. It's up to you to decide which one. But what if you didn't notice there was an empty cell? That's a problem. So go to File, Options, Formulas, Error Checking. There are so many types of error checking happening automatically. Only this one is off. Please enable it immediately. Now it will show you a green icon there, green marker, which is the error marker. That will induce you to think, oh, let me go and see what is the problem. Then it'll say formula is referring to empty cell. Now it may be far away. It'll actually show you an arrow. Double click on the arrow, go there and figure out. Very useful. The next one is also about formula errors. Look at this formula. It's showing a total of 425. Most people will trust that number and take a decision. But have you noticed that green mark? That green mark is trying to tell you that there is a problem. Maybe we know it, but most people won't click on it. Now, many people want to know how to get rid of that green mark. Never show green mark. There is a way, but I won't tell you because it's a good thing. Now click on that green mark. What is it telling you? Formula is omitting adjacent cells. Why is that? Look at the formula. Originally it was correct and then someone added more data and forgot to update the formula. It's a huge problem. If you trust that number, whatever decision you make is going to be wrong because the number is wrong. This is called operational risk. Now, how do you eliminate that risk? Click on that green mark and say update formula. And now you are looking at correct results. The problem is we got inundated with that green mark. We have stopped noticing it. Now, why is it green? Because originally Microsoft has been using red color for comments. They can't use that same color for something else. People will get confused. So they chose red for comments, green for error. Now, green for error doesn't make sense. Green somehow makes us say, okay, it's green, so I don't want to look at it. So what I suggest is go to File, Options, Formulas, and change it to something else. We want some color which indicates danger. Red is taken, so use orange. At least now you will look at it and reduce your risk and increase your accuracy. Now let's talk about Backstage. Backstage in Excel. What is Backstage? Oh, when you press Alt F, go to File menu, hoping a small menu comes, something mammoth comes and occupies the full screen. People get confused and irritated. That thing is called Backstage. It does have a value. I'm going to create a video because many people don't like it and they are missing out a lot of great stuff. But that's for some other video. Now, what happens is we are all used to shortcuts, isn't it? We know Control O is open, Control S, off, Alt F, A, all kinds of shortcuts. The problem is any file related shortcut you use, the shortcut doesn't behave the way you want it to. For example, I want to open a file, Control O. will still open that backstage, and then you have to click on open, then browse. That's very irritating. It's so irritating that people just got inundated and they've given up on it. But fortunately, Microsoft has given us a solution. Not today, not yesterday. Ever since Backstage is there, there is a solution. You will thank me for this. File options, save. In that, you say if I'm using file related shortcuts, do not show Backstage. Immediately do it and you will love it. Have you liked it so far? Put it in comments, ask me questions, and of course subscribe, you know the value by now. Let's talk about data analysis now. Pivot tables, everyone uses. The problem with pivot table is there are so many settings which the default ones you don't like. And then every time you create a pivot table, you have to keep changing the setting again and again and again. Fortunately, there is a better way. You go to File, Options, Data, and then we have pivot table options. So all the options which are available in pivot table are available here, where you can actually set defaults. File options, data, and then go to options for pivot table. One of the things you must change is the layout. Many people don't understand or get confused with the compact form. You should change it to tabular, where the column names are easily seen. Second, very often we adjust the pivot table columns properly and then we refresh and again it auto fits and spoils the show. There is a setting to disable that as well, once and for all future pivot tables. Many times we have a long list of fields in pivot table. By default, the list is in the order in which it's in the data. Generally, that's very non-intuitive, so you can sort it alphabetically by default. Very, very good option. And while we are at it, very often what happens, the field list and those four boxes fight with each other for space. Either this gets filled, that one gets filled, you get confused. So please open that wheel sprocket. There are four different ways in which you can arrange them. Just look at them and choose the right one in the right situation. It will improve the way you create and manipulate pivot tables. Now data, you know what is the biggest bad habit of data? It keeps growing. It never stops. But Excel has a limit of 1 million. And even if you don't reach 1 million, it still becomes sluggish. File open, you wait 10 minutes. Everything you do is slow. What is the solution? Oh, many people still do not know the solution. The solution has been there for more than 10 years. That solution is called data model or Power Pivot. Many people don't even have the Power Pivot menu enabled. So first do this. Immediately go to File, Options, Data, and enable Data Analysis Add-ins. There are two of them. One is the data model or Power Pivot, and the other one, equally good and amazing, 3D maps. How exactly to use data model to manage large amount of data? Large means multi-million rows, fast with small file size. All that I have in a detailed video. Have a look at it. The other one it enables is 3D maps. It's an amazing tool. It is waiting for you to look at it for last 10 years. Go and click on it and you'll be amazed. Anytime you have any data with locational information, please look at it on the map. Even if it's your data, even if it's very familiar to you, map will give you some additional useful and actionable information. I have a video on 3D maps as well. Have a look at it and utilize it in day-to-day work. This is simple data. I can sort it in alphabetical order, ascending, descending, but no. In this case, I don't want Excel to come first. I want Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, OneNote. That is the order. That's custom ordering. Do you know how to do custom ordering? I'm surprised to know this is a 30-year-old feature. Still, people are not aware. How do you create it? File, Options, Advanced. Scroll all the way down. Edit custom lists. I have created a detailed video on this. Have a look at it. And even if you know how to sort and create custom lists, that video will give you at least three more ideas. Most power users are always keyboard savvy. They want keyboard shortcuts. But the problem is every button cannot have a keyboard shortcut. So there will be commands or buttons which you need frequently, but Microsoft has not given them a keyboard shortcut. For example, Format Painter. But I use it often. Wrap text, I use it often, no shortcut. So what do? Right click on it and say add to quick access toolbar. What is that? That's the toolbar which either you see above or below. So now what happened? This thing is clickable. I don't have to search in the menu at least, so it's a mouse shortcut. Now if you want a keyboard shortcut, just press Alt key and release it. You see, all of them got numbers. So now Alt and that number is your keyboard shortcut. Now in this case, our Format Painter got a double number. I don't like that. No problem. You can customize the quick access toolbar, move it up, and then it will get to Alt 1. So remember, Alt 1 to Alt 9, rearrange in such a way that those should be the most commonly used commands with no built-in shortcut. Once you customize the shortcut, you can share it with your colleagues by exporting it and them importing it. And that's also not enough. Create custom toolbar for all products. I have a video on that as well. Now the last one is chart templates, because I see people spending enormous amount of time creating charts. And then because there is a particular way boss likes charts or your customer likes charts, too much amount of time and energy goes in doing fonts and colors and spacing and gradients, 3D. And the problem is next month you have to repeat that process. That's a total waste of your life. Don't do it that way. Do formatting properly once per a kind of chart. Fine. Now right click on the chart and say save as chart template. Notice that the path changes. Leave that alone. Save the template. In this case, it's top 10, so I'm saving it as top 10. Done. Now next time I'm deleting this chart. Assume this data has changed now. It has not, but just assume. Now I'm not going to repeat all that formatting. I'm going to go to this corner button. Now I will see templates. Do not go to the chart, go to templates. Find our template and open it. Now you got exactly the same look and feel with zero formatting effort. So that's how chart templates helps you. Now remember to send the chart templates to your colleagues and ask them to put it in the correct path like I showed you earlier. So that completes Excel top 10 settings. As of now, of course, as Excel evolves and now we are waiting for Copilot and lot of AI infusion, of course, this list can change. Did I miss something? Put it in comments. Did you like it? Then let YouTube know you liked it so that YouTube shares it with more people. And as you know, Microsoft Build is going on. Lot of new things are coming. So watch out for new videos about latest developments, AI and more. Bye bye.